We can stop the rain. Welcome to Decent Life. I'm Lou Pliofito. The call-in number for tonight is 212-245-7273. 212-245-7273. The guidelines for calling in are: lower the volume on your TV or computer. Mm-hmm. Listen to the phone instead of the TV or computer, because we are on an 8-second delay. And if you'd like, you can give your first name, the location where you're calling from, and please, no profanity. This is the first show of the new year, and it's been kind of like a sad start to the year with the terrorists in Paris and the Republicans taking over both the House and the Senate. But, you know, there's still hope and there's still inspiration. And one of the people who inspires me, and I think inspires you, he was on the show previously, is Micaal Stevens. Micaal, welcome to the show again.
How are you doing? Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you too.
Happy New Year. Happy New Year to everybody out there in New York, across the globe, everywhere, east side, west side.
And all around the town.
And of course around the town. You know we love money making Manhattan.
Yeah, of course, I'm not sure, you know, it's been a while since you've been on the show. Mm-hmm. I'm not sure if, you know, if we could introduce yourself to the people, because mm-hmm. you are in a winner, an IFF, which is the International Film Festival of Manhattan.
Yes.
Award. Yes. For your short documentary.
Yes, I won Best Short.
That's terrific. Mm-hmm. And what was so inspiring about this is about your whole life.
Right.
How things got changed around. So yes. If you can, if you like, just give us a little brief thing on some nonsense of
sure.
how your life has been.
Sure. Happy New Year, everyone. Like Lou said, this year started off to a sad start. But I really agree that actually, it's really a great start. You know, if you're living and you're in 2015 and you live and you have life, start being thankful and grateful for what you do have, and don't worry about the things that you don't have. And just be happy that it is a new year. Be happy that you are here with us, and just be happy that you can go. So I would like to say again, Happy New Year. Hope everyone is well out there. My name is Micaal Stevens.
And just to say, that's very inspirational, what you just said. You see, I tell you, this guy can really bring it to you and inspire you, and we all can work together to do good things.
Yeah, we have to have a decent life, and we need the thing. Well, see, the thing about it, Lou, is this. The more you're thankful and you're grateful and you're genuine about mm-hmm. being that, then you're always well. Because I have a saying, it always could be worse.
That's right. And for you, it was worse a long time ago.
So what happened was the way that we met, he's correct. Last year, I did a documentary, and it's called Mr. Real to Real. And I was in the IFFM Film Festival, and you came, and you saw some films, and you were interested, and he really liked the film. So from that point on, I won Best Short.
Well, not because of me.
Well, yeah.
Because so, you're closer to
right.
the
and movie, the documentary shows how I went from a negative lifestyle to a more civilized lifestyle. And it was a very, very good, you know, same project, and it helped me out a lot, and it's been very, very great, and that's how we met. But I'm back this year.
Okay.
And I'm in New York, and I'm finishing the feature.
Okay, let's talk about what the feature and the short documentary was about, mm-hmm. because I thought it was amazing how you changed your life around. And so let's start at the beginning. How you were saying that you were on the streets?
Yeah, well,
drug dealer or whatever.
Well, the documentary is based on me being from Roosevelt, Long Island, and me growing up in Harlem. And me making the unfortunate choices to not follow school and sports, and I followed urban living, and I followed hustling and drug dealing and those things. And it led me to being incarcerated multiple times, and I did a lot of prison time, and I came home, and I was looking for a way to change, and God just opened up a door for me and led me to an open call, and I went to an open call for a film, and I booked it. And that gave me the opportunity to leave the negative lifestyle that I was about, and I took advantage of it, and but I just ran away with it.
Wasn't it like an interesting part was that you really didn't want to go? Weren't you just bringing a friend?
Well, no. Well,
what exactly was going on?
Yeah. What happened was one of my friends took me out to a nightclub, and I hung out. And on the way home, I heard about the commercial for the open call, and I told a family member, and it was one of my cousins. And mm-hmm. the day of the open call, I forgot about it. I didn't even want to really go. And he was like, "Hey, man, we should go to this." And I told him no, and he kept pushing me, and that was just God, and he opened up a door for me, and I ended up going to the open call, ended up booking it.
Yeah, and, well, We have a little clip here. Is that the same open call that you went to that first acting judge? So this is basically the first clip. This is the spot that you got.
Well, no. This the first clip is my first film.
Okay.
My first independent film.
Okay.
But there is a clip from the actual film that I got the open call from.
Okay. And is it, what was the name of the film?
Belly. It was a film called Belly. It was a director by the name of Hype Williams, and he did this film called Belly. It was starring Nas, which is a rapper, and DMX, which is also a rapper. They were the two lead roles.
Right.
And the film was about my ex-life. It was about my former life.
Right.
And it had one character that wanted to continue doing the life I used to do, and one character that was like, we don't need to do this anymore. So it was that Cain and Abel / devil here, God here. So it's one of those kind of
but
films.
Where was it where you made the decision that you didn't want to lead a life of, I don't know what you would call it, down the wrong path? Were you in prison? Where was it where you said, what the heck am I doing here?
I got civilized. That's it. Because, see, you're either uncivilized or you're savage. And when I was doing, when you're civilized and you're savage, it's two different streams. So I wasn't conscious. What I thought I was doing, I just got tired of it. And when you get incarcerated, and you're constantly incarcerated, and you're hurting friends, you're hurting family, you're hurting children, you're hurting loved ones, it gets to a point where you have to be conscious. So a light bulb went off, and I think my heart opened up. It went from cold to warm, and that was it.
But why is it some guys just can't?
Faith, spirit. You have to have the faith in the spirit.
Well, let's just see this first clip that you brought with us. Just give me a second. Oh, let me give me a second to bring it up. And just let me know if I'm on the right one. Is this the one?
Well, which one are we doing?
The first, one.
Yeah, the first film. That's my first film right
okay,
here.
Okay, so let's...
Ice Grill, the realest movie ever.
Right now!
That's 1998.
Oh, shit.
Roosevelt.
What's the deal, my nigga? Psycho Side.
A John Stewart film.
Hempstead.
You know how we do, man. I'm going to stop.
Critics call it the realest movie ever.
Is there used to be a track out there?
Roosevelt Raceway, yeah. That's in Long Island. This is the scene uptown where one of my friends was murdered in the film. So this is a film that opened up doors for independent filmmakers. This movie called Ice Grill.
Yo, they beat me last night. Yo, this shit is crazy, son. I can't even fucking sleep, son, all night. Word is born. That's fucking Bronco, God. What the fuck, y'all, put my niggas? What's it gonna be, God?
Do what we gotta do, man.
You gonna swarm these niggas tonight? Motherfucking Bronco, nigga!
Everybody from this film is going on to produce.
Why you saying shit like that? That's fucking Bronco, dog.
He's a good alumni.
Word is born. That's
alumni.
My man.
You gotta get this.
You know I, yo, sir. You know how I get down when it come to y'all niggas. I'm psycho too, nigga. You psycho style.
For whatever, son. We do what we got.
Fuck them niggas.
Yo. Check this out, man. That niggas ain't got the brain to fuck with the Snicker Bowl guard. You know what I mean? Niggas want some other shit.
And York Entertainment in California put this movie out.
Man, you think niggas won't when niggas will, son?
Nah, fuck that.
And the Ice Grill All-Stars.
And this nigga mad late. I ain't no pussy. If y'all fucked up, I hit y'all niggas again. I got another half a joint in the car right now. I hit you right now. Get my money. See this nigga here, son?
And this is the bad guy in the movie that killed my
You want this nigga around?
This is what happens when you do bad things.
Yo, you got my man!
Yeah, that was the first film. So that was my first film.
All right, that was terrific.
It was an independent film. I went to the audition, and I never knew that it was going to take off. And it was really a plateau for independent filmmakers. Like that movie Ice Grill helped people to know I can do a movie too. So I was like mayor. I was the mayor all over New York when that film dropped. So it was a good start for the career, and also showed me what not to do and what to do on camera. So it was a very good learning
experience.
Oh, big time. But I jumped right in. I mean, I got the role and I just went in. So it was really, really okay. Amazing.
So where are we now? Because I know you said you were doing a full feature.
Well, after being an actor from 97 until present, mm-hmm. it gets to a point where you have to do your Mark Wahlberg thing. You have to go into your own, you know, Spike Leroy. Mm-hmm. You got to just
Marky
do it.
Mark and Mark Wahlberg.
Hey, I love both of them. He's the man. He's my inspiration. I love him. So I love him. I love Diddy. I love anybody that can really, really do it. So basically, I made the transition from hardworking actor to a filmmaker, because everybody has a story, but some people's stories you can't really pay. You know, there's nothing there. I have a lot of friends that are actors, but there's nothing there. You know, they've been good their whole lives.
Well, how about you? How about your friends? Did you leave these other guys behind? You left the street behind?
Yeah, I left the street behind.
Did they try to pull you back in?
Oh my! Let me tell you, I reached out recently. Uh-huh. You ready for this? Uh-huh. I reached out recently to a buddy. I said, "Hey, my film is almost done. I need some help. I need some money." You know, he offered me a role back in the game. He said, "Hey, man, I can still use you."
Oh really? Yeah.
Yeah. He offered me a position.
Yeah.
I'm like, really? You know, so they just don't get it. Don't get it. I try.
Well, it's more about the money and that whole glamour
thing. It's easy.
It's not about family, because I really think that you had people behind you to help you get there. And some people don't. You have a family behind you?
Well, unfortunately, I grew up kind of like the black sheep. And I didn't handle conflict well. I didn't handle anger well. So I have people that still think I'm the old me.
Oh yeah.
And they don't think I'm the new me. So
well, you know, it takes a lot of work, because you know what? Because you know, anger comes from frustration and not understanding.
Mm-hmm.
And you really need to have empathy for the other person to understand where they're coming from. And at least that's what I try to do. So I don't try not to lash out, because this show is all about to really change the world.
Right.
You need to know how to love each other.
Right.
And you can't go out and just attack.
No, you can't.
You need to have the understanding, take the high road in whatever you do.
People always say, why are you so happy and positive? Because I've been negative and mean. What are you talking about?
So now you balanced it out. You balanced it out now.
But you get nowhere. You get nowhere being mean and ugly. And that's what I try to tell people. Because look, in society.
I can name a few people.
Look. I go to society every day and I say good morning. I say hello to people.
Yeah.
And you will not imagine the amount that look at me like, what did you say to me? And I speak well.
Yeah.
So if I say good morning to you, there's no mystery of what I just said.
Yeah.
And people are just angry. That's what I tell people all the time. If you're thankful and you're grateful and you're genuine, you're going to be peaceful.
Because what it is they want more. And they're not happy with what they have. And everybody wants more, more, more.
But they don't understand. That's a sin. That's called gluttony. You know?
That's for sure.
And you can't be judgmental with your sins. You have to. So I try to pass on love.
Hold on, we got a call coming.
No, we got a call.
Hello, you're on Decent Life.
Yes, can I make a comment?
Sure.
Okay, you know, I agree with you when you said that part of the, anger, part of anger comes from a lot of frustration. But I also believe that a lot of these negative feelings that we have comes from, I read the Bible a little. Hello, can you hear me? I read the Bible a little bit. I'm not, really religious, but from what I understand, the Bible is saying that people condition the nervous system. They program the nervous system. They program the way they think, feel, say, and do things. And so this takes over this rules over anything else. So the only way you can change the that behavior is to reprogram yourself to something more positive. And that's what I understand from.
Yes, yeah. positive thoughts will bring forth positive action. The more you're positive about anything, you will always look, we have two natures as humans. We have a negative nature and a positive nature. And the one that you cultivate is going to make you at the end of the day. That's it.
That's right. And thank you for your call. All right. And that's very true, but you know what, it's interesting. I really believe that everyone's born loving.
Yes.
If you look at a newborn child, they want to belong, they want to love, they want to join in,
Yes.
But it's everything outside. So the programming that he talked about is
the frequency.
All the outside tugging in, because every child is an angel.
But you know what else too? We as a people need to stop accepting negativity from people. See, too many people in life, they sweep dirt up under the rug. They see somebody going through something and they just, yeah, okay, and they walk away from them and they say, that person's a...
Oh.
Talk to people. Be honest with people. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Give back the right way.
I think, because, you know, I have a discussion with a few people saying that you need to tell people that they're doing wrong.
Yeah, totally.
You cannot accept it, because by not saying anything, they're going to keep on doing
it. You make it worse. You make by you being quiet, you make a situation worse.
That's right. Just to make a long story short, one day I was walking on 2nd Avenue and I was going down one of these blocks. Mm-hmm. This old man's crossing the street in between the block, and this car comes, scaring the old guy.
It's negative.
And he's not going anywhere because there's a red light. You're not going anywhere. You didn't make a turn in New York City, you're hitting a red light.
I know, it's just terrible.
So I'm just walking, and the guy pulls over, and he's going, rolls down the way, and he's going to start berate this old man. So I went over and said, what are you doing?
Yeah.
You know, to let him know.
And that's all it took was for you to do that.
That's right. So what are you doing? He's an old guy, and you're not going anywhere. What's this point here?
It's negative.
And you know what he said at the end? Oh, stop being a good Samaritan. But anyway.
That's funny.
It's funny. And then you get other people who, like on the subway, this guy leans his back on the pole, and everybody's holding their hands. And I'm saying, excuse me. And the people around me are so scared that saying, don't say anything. And I said, I can't do this. And I talked to him politely.
Right. Exactly.
I said, excuse me, you know, I'm not sure if you understand the etiquette.
So you have to do. Yeah. Some people do that just for attention. They're just attention grabbers.
They care about themselves.
That's right.
Because
in
this world, you see in the media, it's always me.
Right.
Gratification for myself and not somebody else.
Right.
I walked.
We have a call.
Oh, do we?
Yeah.
There we go. Thank you for looking, because I'm so
involved.
I'm talking to you. Okay. Hi, you're on Decent Life.
Yes. I have sneakers.
Okay. Thank you for that comment. And then you have people who don't understand. And the only way they know how is to lash out.
And you got to teach them.
And that was that phone call was about. They have no idea.
Right.
And somehow we need to,
Well, we need to set a fine example. That's how we do. We set a fine example. Yeah. You crush people. Because like, just like the situation that I have right now, you know, 2015 brought forth a lot of situations. And especially with the, you know, police versus civilians.
Yeah.
Now, my only take on it is that they're not all bad cops.
That's right.
Just like they're not all bad teachers.
That's right.
Like they're not all bad parents. I mean, some of us as human beings, as brothers and sisters and fathers and mothers, we're bad people. So, you know, you can't, you know, it's a saying, I grew up with saying, you can't be the pot calling the kettle black.
That's right.
You know, so basically, you know, this year has brought forth a lot. Like people have been constantly hitting me up saying, how do I feel about the situation?
Yeah.
Well, me being from the negative world, dealing with police my whole life, there's just two ways to deal with them. The easy way or the hard way.
Okay.
And your actions and your mouth will determine how it's going to happen.
That's right.
So, my people out there that's going through...
But sometimes it's still unavoidable.
But
some people still
but you know what? You still don't win by going the other way.
That's right.
Look.
Yep. No, you're right. You're right.
Look. I've been beat up by cops because I made the situation happen. I've also been manhandled by cops, and the more I went the opposite direction with it, the more they were like, oh, I'm sorry. And but it's how you handle yourself. And you have to realize something else too, Lou. I tell my friends all the time. If you have a profession, if you have a career, if you're a student, those people I know have no problems with police. None. The people I know that hustle, and they drug deal, and they rob, and they steal, they have problems with police.
All right.
So learn how to get a profession, get a career, and get a life. And you will not have problems with law enforcement.
Well, and that's why you're here, as an inspiration from going from a bad spot to a good spot. And so what I like to do is, because, you know, we're talking so much, we're having a good conversation, I really want to concentrate more on documentary. Do you want to show another clip?
Let's do it.
All right. So which one would you like to do now?
There you go. There's a doc. Let's show them this.
Okay, let's show a few minutes of this.
Yeah, of course.
Is the story of how in 1997, I took an open call and made it into a 16-year career. My adrenaline, rise to lose, battlefield certified, I done paid due. My adrenaline, my drive nonstop.
What you call me?
Wise man told me a long time ago, when you try hard and you put your best foot forward, always have positive results. And that's what I did. Kept my head up and stayed focused. And this is my story. In 1997, I was released from Broad River Correctional Institution in Columbia, South Carolina. The night before I was released, I told myself,
give me a taste of it.
I said, self, you've given almost 10 years of your life to incarceration. Between jail and between prison time, it's almost added up to 10 years. And I made an oath to myself at that time that I would never come back to prison again. One of my friends told me before I got out, he said, well, it's only two things right now that I feel like are the biggest money makers. And he said, that's marijuana, and that's the black market business. When I came home, those are the only two options that I had. And those are the two options that I ventured out for. Once you get in trouble and you become a product of the system, you start getting incarcerated, it's a wrap. Society doesn't really respect you anymore. They don't look at it like you made a mistake. They don't judge it that way. So I went to New York and I left Columbia, South Carolina to meet up with some Jamaicans that I knew. And I knew that they would have the best prices.
All right.
Yeah.
I tell you.
Happy New Year.
Yeah. And you know, the more I see this, it's inspirational. Like last week I had another person on who had a dream of doing something where a lot of people are negative towards, because he's wrapping trees, mm-hmm. and a lot of people go, oh, what, you're making a living out of that?
Right.
So he kept on 7 years, 8 years, and now he's being recognized for his art.
Nice.
And the same thing here, you can't let people tell you anything. You have what you believe, what's in your heart, what is right, and you continue. So when should we expect to see the full feature?
Now I'm really excited. I'm home. There are some pivotal scenes that are in the feature that I had to come home to reshoot.
Right.
They're being added now. The film, the feature should be, we thought I'd be done January 1st. But, you know, it just didn't work out. You know, being a first-time filmmaker, you know, and just thinking that I can wing it, didn't happen.
We do have another phone call.
Let's do it.
Hello, you're on Decent Life.
Yeah, I have a comment. Yeah, I want to say that from observing the fellow here, is that, you know, that's like an isolation case to me, because you can apply, I can apply it to myself, and apply that same thing to everybody else.
No, hold on. Listen. My story is about sacrifice. My story is about how I could be a plumber, I could be a doctor, I could be anything I want to be, but I made a sacrifice to go from negative, from 1982 until 1997, I was negative and I was a criminal. From 97 until present, I'm not. So that's what my story is about. It's not about film, TV, commercial. It's about making a conscious decision to go from wrong to right. That's it. So if you can't relate to that, then you're not human. And that's it.
No. Are you still on?
Well, you know, I understand what you're saying. But look, not every boxer is going to be another Muhammad Ali.
It's not about that.
Jennifer Lopez, you know what I'm saying? So what I'm trying to say is that you got to look at the whole picture. I mean, and the whole picture is that, you know, a lot of, you know, what's happening here is that There are no jobs, okay? So they say, but the society say, look, there are no jobs for these people, no decent housing, we're not waiting for them, so let's lock them all up, throw the key away, and there'll be no problem.
Stay positive.
No, I understand what you're saying. Everything around you is dragging you another way. But you know what
is? There's people that made it out from where he's at. People that made it out.
But what he's trying to say, it's hard to do that. And you know what is? If you made it out and you were just a cab driver, you're out.
Exactly.
You're just doing movies. But the thing is to do something to not go down that line, and it's very hard unless you have the support to.
You have to support yourself.
It's like a 50% unemployment of black kids. 50% unemployment. You know what I'm saying? It's not 2% or 1%.
Okay. Thank you. I have to cut you short because I have one more phone call. Thank
Keep
you.
Your eyes. Stay positive.
Hello, you're on Decent Life.
Yes. This would be such a beautiful world to live in if all the blacks were dead.
Yeah,
all
right. She's right.
All right.
Yeah. You know, people like that, you tell them they're right. Just
no,
so
I'm not, I can't argue with him.
But you messed the head up. You say you're right. You tell them you're right. You tell them you're beautiful and you're right.
Well,
that's
just,
all.
Just look at it this way. You know, everybody's entitled to their opinion.
I love them.
You know?
It's like a, you know what, and everybody got one.
Yep. I love them. So now, listen.
Well, you know what? We need the opposite to learn from.
Yeah.
To learn what not to do.
Exactly.
You know? That's what, because you know why my son's so good? He learned from me what not to do.
Exactly. So now, look.
Learn from the mistakes.
Right? We're in a new year. This is a great time to be living right now with all the technology, with everything they have available. This is a great time to live.
It is.
People, be happy, be positive. So the film will be dropping in March.
What happened is people who talk like that, they need to understand that we need to work together. We're all in one boat. And not one race or religion is responsible for your problems. Well, it's just bad people.
She needs a hug. And she
there
needs sex. She needs sex
okay.
and a hug.
And you know what? Micaal, we ran out of time.
Like
it's a pleasure to come here. And you know, guys like you, you know,
like us,
we can stop the rain, and all we need is love.
There's no I,
good night, everybody.
Us, we ours.